Are you ready for a Korn album review? Korn Requiem album review. Korn's discography can only be described with one term, and that is roller coaster. Let's see which direction we're being flung this time in 2022. With
Requiem.
First, we gotta look at the definition of a requiem, because that's a big word, and I don't know what it means off the top of my head. Requiem is a mass for the repose of the souls of the dead. Ooh, spooky. Suitable enough for a Korn album title, right? Band that has nearly wallowed in misery for 30 years. Can you believe it? I think we're at like the 28 year mark with this one. And this album certainly retains that part of the Korn mythos. Ridicule, cule, sickness, anger, sadness are all over this thing. You don't have to worry. They're there. There are a few moments of hope sprinkled into the middle of this record, but even the most hopeful tracks are anger-filled tirades of despair. So, the biggest difference between Requiem and other Korn albums is their use of restraint here. I always groan when I see an album with less than 10 tracks, and I certainly did some groaning when I saw the track list of Requiem. But here, I feel like this is actually a wise decision on Korn's part. Nearly every Korn album is bloated, even the good ones, with an hour-plus marathon of misery. And I respect Korn for branching out on their later albums. They really went for the experimentation, and they were bold, but many of their experiments just didn't work for you or I, or him, or the dog in there.
Fruit Loops!
This is a band that had four classic albums, followed by four experimental albums, followed by an album literally called Remember Who You Are. And then this is the nerve of these guys, immediately forgetting who they are on the next record.
I'm looking at you, man!
Requiem is 9 songs that hardly ever reach the 4-minute mark, and you get face, and you're out for the count. It actually does more to recapture the classic Korn sound than Korn 3 Remember the 90s did, and it has more memorable songs than much of their latter catalog. Now, speaking of latter Korn, I'm actually a big stan of Nothing. I vibe with Nothing. And this album really continues the upward trend for me in terms of the Korn tree.
Baby, I was Korn tree!
That was a Kid Rock parody. Thank you.
Best was indeed saved for last on this record. The best song on the record is ironically called The Worst Is On Its Way. And it's a glorious closer to a pretty decent Korn album in 2022. If you have more than 3 minutes of free time to kill, I suggest Lost in the Grandeur as well.
I have problems!
Overall, Requiem is a good entry in the ever-growing graveyard of Korn victims. And I'm giving this album a solid 3 beatings out of 5. That's right, 3 out of 5 for Korn Requiem. My re-ranking of the Korn discography is in the works right now, and my top 10 Korn songs is already out on the channel, so you don't even have to wait for that one. Just go ahead and subscribe and watch it. And if you're a miserable Korn fan like I am, you'll subscribe for even more torture like this. Thank you. Subscribe.
I'm so happy. My Korn review is over. I gave it 3. What did I give it? 3 out of 5. 3 out of 5. 3 out of 5. I'm gonna go with something happy like, "Die, die, die, my darling," or "Mommy, can I go out to kill tonight?" Robo and Jerry, Danzig and Doyle, Robo.